I think what Evo was doing is they did realize that they had the team fight dominance over Pentachill. So even though the team composition is a little trolly, they do have the AoE in order to fight those team fights. And I think in the team fights, they are going to have an advantage. Just the amount of area of effect, silence, and crowd control they can have. Nunu ultimate, of course, is going to root everybody in place. A stun on Taric. And don't forget, the ultimate on Varus is also going to bounce from target to target, rooting every single member of Pentachill in place. Pentachill did have a problem where they grouped up in those team fights, and Brand ultimate absolutely decimated them last game. So if Pentachill learned from that mistake and can spread out, the interesting team comp that TSM Evo here is running, probably not going to have the best time in the world, but if they do just get a little bit antsy and group together to go into those team fights, I think Evo might actually have a little bit of an advantage.
Well, Evo has the advantage of simply being professional players that have now played together and, you know, had the experience of playing in a major tournament, and that doesn't matter quite as much in lane, but it really does matter in the team fights when you've spent a lot of time playing together. You know how each person likes to, what, you know, the individual play style of each player, where they tend to do. You know, you can't always type or talk of every single little thing that you want to do. That's where the experience of having played together and played in big matches comes into favor there. So we'll see. Both teams have bought nearly identical items, but we do have the boots and two wards start on the Lulu player right there. So that's a more aggressive start, delaying the fairy charm, delaying your philosopher's stone right there. Otherwise, everybody boots three pots, pretty standard right now for starting items in League of Legends.
And it looks like TSM Evo identified that the Pentachill was going to be going for a blue steal. Amumu is a very blue-dependent jungler. He is going to need that to really power through with his Tantrum and his Despair tiers in order to farm through his jungle. So just completely bypassing the jungle invade, looks like both teams are going to be going on their opponent's blue buffs, and that's just going to be how the game starts off. Scalamant on Nautilus is going to start off with a blue buff, so he's probably going to power through his jungle, potentially going for an early gank on middle or bottom lane if they show up in time. That is the main question here at these invades. Meanwhile, Amumu is just going to power through his jungle with a blue buff and then just do what he wants to do. Actually, it looks like they're going to reverse invade and just decide to go ward their enemy blue buff, and now with a minute 30 on the clock, they have 20 seconds left to get over to that blue buff before Pentachill is going to start on it, but I actually don't know what TSM Evo is doing here.
Pentachill should not be looking to level one fight here. TSM Evo has Taric and Blitz, which is a really, really strong level one team comp. They should not be looking to fight this. They need to get out of here, and this could go very badly for them. Let's see what happens.
I would say Aphromoo found out the hard way that Anivia was in that bush where he ate a chunk of ice to the face. Tangy Time did recall back to the top lane, as did Wings of Death. So with that damage from Aphromoo, it looks like TSM Evo is not really going to be able to contest this blue buff. He just took a little bit too much damage at the beginning there from the stun and just all the auto attacks. So Nautilus will get away with this blue buff. Actually, looked like he wanted to finish it off with the lizard so that he could get a timer on it, but he's going to leave it completely alive. So there's going to be no reset on that blue buff. That could be very bad for TSM Evo. And he actually looks, no, he's not going to be going for a gank in the middle lane. He's just going to trudge over onto his own blue buff, try to stop Amumu from taking it. And this is going to be very interesting. Unstoppable did start with Despair, so he's going to be burning through a lot of mana on his Amumu build with boots and three health potions. I don't know if he's going to be able to take a lot of the jungle very quickly.
That's a really nice play for Pentachill, taking that blue buff. Leaving the one lizard is going to screw over Amumu pretty badly. Their jungler, Nautilus, he did want to finish that off just because it would have gotten him to level 2. That little lizard at the enemy team's blue buff would have gotten him to level 2. The reason why TSM Evo couldn't fight that is Wings of Death, their Blitz player, had already left and gone to top lane. So he was not there, which meant that they couldn't fight and they had to just give up their blue. So that ended up costing them. If Blitz had stayed with them a little bit longer and had not headed off the top, then they likely could have fought that and presumably would have won, just because Blitz Crank Grab and Taric Stun are so strong at level 1. Now, the team for Pentachill, not a terrible level 1 team. They did have the Anivia Stun, and Nautilus is not too bad. Nautilus and Graves are also pretty solid in level 1 fights, but, I mean, if somebody gets hooked into the enemy team, it's pretty much just all over. So Pentachill really played better in that little level 1 whole encounter there. They were able to get the blue away from Amumu, and they are able to get two blues onto Nautilus, so he's actually ahead.
Yeah, Namu looks like he actually had to go for a red buff. Nautilus coming for a gank, misses the dredge line. Anivia will, however, land the stun. Saucy just juking through the bush. He is going to get tagged, though, by the staggering glow from Nautilus. Looks like with that blood boil, it's going to be A-OK. Does have to burn the flash, though, so Nautilus does get a successful gank off by burning the flash. Amumu coming around towards his wolves. He actually has the red buff, but had to go back immediately. So he's only level 2 compared to Nautilus at level 3 right now. And as he's mentioned, he has picked up two blue buffs to Amumu's 0. And Amumu looks like the sad mummy is going to be even more upset when he comes over and he finds that one lone lizard. So Unstoppable, blue buffless, for at least the next 5 minutes right now. So we're not even going to see a blue buff spawning for TSM Evo's jungle until about the 9 minute and 15 second mark, not 19 minutes. That's way too long for the blue buff spawns. But still, denying the resources, Pentachill could potentially have another very, very good early game.
Unstoppable is really, really far behind. Again, I think most people have played League of Legends a lot and probably heard this before, but Amumu is just so blue buff dependent. You take it away from him, and he just has so much trouble farming because he runs out of mana in like 30 seconds. So he's already had to recall once. He's going to have to recall again after he does his Golem camp here. And is this going to... I'm not sure this is going to take him to level 4. I'm not 100% sure. But he is really, really far behind Nautilus right now. So he's not going to be able to gank much in the early game. And indeed, no, it's not going to take him to 4. So he's had to back twice before he hit level 4. He's not going to hit 4 until about 5:30. So he is really far behind.
And we do see a lot of aggression on top lane. Wings of Death chasing down, actually flashing Indic for the kill on Kennen. He's going to take a lot of tower shots. The mana barrier procs. And that is a bad move from Wings of Death. Did not have the pull up at all. So he just decided to try to tower dive Kennen. Kennen with those moves speed quints a little bit too fast with the lightning rush too. Able to bait Blitzcrank into tower diving and picks up first blood because of this. Meanwhile, on the bottom lane, we do see that Afremu and Taric have been pushed back to their tower a little bit. And I want to point out very quickly, Afremu going against his own Varus build. He's actually picked up 2 points in Piercing Arrow rather than maxing out the Blighted Quiver first. For all you people that read those guides out there, I don't know. He's not following his own. So it's a very interesting predicament that they've been in right now. TSM Evo, I don't know. Last game, we saw them falling apart at the early stages of the game to just the sheer gank presence of that Nocturne for Team Pentachill. But right now, they're doing basically the same thing. They're having a little bit of an awkward early game, but could they potentially come back in the late game? We're just going to have to find that out, Sola.
Evo's not in a great position right now. Bottom lane is actually pretty much dead even. Haven't seen any real difference. Both champions pretty much on equal minion kills. Not really a whole lot of difference there. But for Evo, their jungler is really far behind. Unstoppable has just managed to hit level 4. He is going to have to go back to base again soon. He's just done the simple jungle route. He's done wolves, wraiths, golems, and he's going to have to go back to base again for the third time already in 6 minutes. So he's just so far behind. Meanwhile, in top lane, Tangy Time with that first blood has really helped him out. He was in a little bit of trouble. He was getting bullied around a little bit, but that first blood helps him out tremendously. It was a great reaction time. Wings of Death flashed in. Tangy Time just immediately flashed back before he could get hit with a Power Fist. So really nicely played right there. Anivia has almost gotten past her early weak levels. She's taking a lot of damage to that snowball, is behind in lane. Not tremendously, but is definitely behind. Definitely needs to get that blue buff when it respawns, which it will in about 1 minute because they didn't take the blue immediately when it spawned. But now that DC Buddha is level 6, he'll be able to farm much, much more easily because he can just turn on his ultimate and he doesn't have to get that close to Salsi. Salsi, though, has been putting on some really good harass with that snowball. He deals, if you highlight the skill, he deals about 200 damage every time that it comes off of cooldown, and he can cast it for free when he auto attacks due to Nunu passive. So he's been putting on a lot of pressure there in mid. But as we said in the staging room, AP Nunu, yeah, he's great in lane, but then what happens after, you know, you get out of the laning phase? Well, he doesn't really do that much. So, and we'll see how that goes, but I would say that Pentachill's in a pretty good position right now. As long as they can just keep farming these lanes, they're in pretty good shape.
Ooh, looks like Salsi is going to pop that Nunu ultimate. He's actually going to make DC Buddha burn that flash, and Buddha is going to go back because of this. But Salsi, with that Blood Boil and the positioning on his snowballs, he's just doing a really great job of zoning out Anivia. Meanwhile, we see it in the top lane, Wings of Death getting extremely low, going up against Tangy Time. He is going to take down Tangy Time this time. That 58 mana on the mana shield, keeping him alive. So it was a very well executed or a very lucky play from Wings of Death in the top lane there, as we did see he and Kennen continuing to trade blows in that top lane from time to time. Meanwhile, then Amumu did go back. He actually had to sell one of his 3 health potions he had to pick up a Philosopher's Stone on that, what was the second or third back he's gotten so far. He is only level 5, taking his second red buff. Nautilus, actually level 5 too, has his own Philosopher's Stone. Taking a quick look at the money in the bank, he does have 600 saved up though, so he is still just a little bit ahead of Amumu. Amumu's doing a really great job of catching up though, has to go back yet again, but Nautilus really hasn't been ganking all too often or really pushing any sort of advantage out of the jungle.
No, the one difference is that Scantonman, the Nautilus player, has now hit 6, and he is going to be able to get his Heart of Gold really soon when he goes back to base. So it looks like he's picked bottom lane as the lane to try to focus. Bottom lane is basically dead even. There's no difference in here right now. One thing that you can point out, though, is he could perhaps be, you know, he instead of ganking bottom lane, he could potentially have looked to finish clearing his jungle round. He could have gone to Wraith, then to Wolves, and then go to blue and be getting blue for his mid, just because Anivia is one of the most blue-dependent APs. Instead, he's not really achieving that much down here in bot, but if he's able to pull off a successful gank, it will all be worthwhile, so we'll just have to see what he's able to do. Oh, he stepped out of the brush down there in bottom lane.
So it looks like they might be going for a tower dive. They do know that Taric had gone back. Depth charge actually lands on Aphramu despite flashing. Meanwhile, we see Wings of Death pick up a kill in the top lane on Kennen. Gray's ultimate goes off. Aphramu is going to fall to Nautilus, and they actually see Amumu coming in here to try to counter that gank. So actually knowing that the support character was gone and the range carry was all by himself, just opting to go for a tower dive. No one took all too much damage. We did see in the top lane, though, Blitzcrank. That poor Kennen is just getting bullied around by nothing but armor pen on that Blitzcrank. And interestingly enough, he's leveling up his rocket grab, which has an ability power ratio, as opposed to going for either cooldown reduction on the power fist or maxing out overdrive for more auto attacks with the armor penetration. So a very interesting Blitzcrank build, and it's actually working for Wings of Death in top lane.
It looks like top lane has been the weakest lane for Pentachill in both games. Both games, Wings of Death has really gotten ahead just in laning matchup. He really should have gotten the first blood in this match until he messed up his flash under the tower. So for whatever reason, Tangy Time is just not having a good day. Just not having a good day here in this particular matchup has really struggled here against Wings of Death. And at this point, it looks like the Wings of Death is just going to snowball ahead at this point. He's leading once again in farm. He has now picked up Sheen, one of the key items for Blitz, whether he's building support or AP or really whatever. Just such a great item on him because of the way it scales with his passive. I am indeed surprised that Power Fist is not being leveled up. So perhaps this is some kind of an AP Blitz build, which would be extremely unorthodox, but maybe that's what he's going for, since he is maxing up, as you said, that Rocket Fist first.
It's very interesting. I think he does have a null magic mantle, but he only has level 1 boots right now, so he's probably going to be turning those into Mercury Treads. He could be going for Trinity Force, and just the amount of damage that could be at a burst when he does pull Kennen could be enough to really just put up an argument for leveling the Rocket Grab first. Nunu in the middle, though. Anivia does have a blue buff. Ignite goes down. She is going to get egged right there. Nunu not taking a lot of damage. One thing that Salsi does have over most AP mids playing that Nunu is a lot of HP. So even though Anivia has that blue buff and was able to get the critical strike on her Frostbite, there was just not enough damage to really stop Nunu from just throwing snowballs and auto-attacking the Anivia down into egg form. With the blue buff now, Salsi did pick that up on the delay, and that is another thing we forgot to point out. Nautilus delayed the enemy team's blue buff for so long by keeping that lizard alive, and Amumu did not clear it out until the 4 minute and 15 second mark, but they did not give Anivia the blue, so now the blue timers are relatively even on the middle, so there's no advantage from that. Yeah, bottom lane, we do see that Lulu is actually getting a lot of damage, actually taking the Taric stun. She is going to ult herself to try to save here. Graze is continuing to go down on Aphramu, though. Varus getting very, very low. He does not look like he's going to fall. Lulu's actually going to fall here. The Curse of the Sad Mummy goes off to no avail. Lulu is already dead. Graze is going to get out of there barely, as it looks like Amumu missed the bandage toss there, and Aphramu's arrow was not enough to take him down. Scallop Man has come down here just to run around in circles and deter anybody from trying to push the tower too hard. But still, TSM Evo now, their jungler didn't really make too much of a difference there, but I think the key misstep from Pentachill in the bottom lane there was Lulu burning the ultimate on herself,
yes,
when she was actually out of fight range.
That's exactly right, Tom. Lulu misplayed the ult. I'm not going to write you used ult on Lulu when it actually wasn't needed. If the ult needed to go on the Graves, and if that had come out at the right time and gotten the knockup, then they would definitely have won that fight. We also had a really nice exhaust coming out from Nat Nguyen, the Taric support player on TSM Evo. He used his exhaust at just the right moment, just when it looked like Graves was going to get the kill. All of a sudden, his damage is cut to nothing. And the result of that fight, Evo is able to take a dragon in the aftermath of that encounter.
Yeah, so a kill and a dragon in favor of TSM Evo. 3-2 now. They still have about a 2,000 gold advantage. No towers have yet to be taken, but they're having a lot stronger of an early game than they did last game, which is interesting because this composition, you wouldn't think it really worked, but just the teamwork from TSM Evo coming out with those bottom lanes and the top lane, just Wings of Death somehow dominating Tangy Times Kennen with that Blitzcrank build. It's just really working out in their favor, and I don't really know what the difference is from last game right now.
The difference from last game is just that top lane is snowballed ahead once again for TSM Evo, but the jungle ganks haven't been there. Nautilus really, he made the play in bottom lane, but other than that, we haven't seen Nautilus too much. He really hasn't done a whole lot in this game. So even though Amumu has been really weak, Pentachill did a great job of shutting down Amumu. So even though Amumu hasn't really made himself felt on this game, Nautilus hasn't really made himself felt on this game too much either. And so that's really the difference, because in last game, if you remember, when we saw that last game, Pentachill's Nocturne jungler was just really ganking everywhere all over the map and did a really nice job of that. And we haven't really seen that same pressure, although right now, we do have that ult coming out in bottom lane.
Yeah, depth charge goes down onto Aphromoo's Varus. He is going to get back in the tower range on the side to deal some damage on the Nat and wins Taric, but it doesn't look like they're going to be too much. Actually, Dark Knight Grey is taking a lot of damage there, as is Varus arrows. When maximum range, have a 1.7 AD ratio, and even at shortest range, it's a 1.1 AD ratio. So with Aphromoo on 134 damage, he is going to be dealing a lot with those arrows. We do, meanwhile, see that Salsi is going to pick up a kill on Anivia while running through, it looks like behind her tower towards the jungle. So all this pressure is on the bottom lane, Salsi just being super tanky and leveling up consume to level 4. He's just constantly taking tower shots, taking aggression, eating a minion, and then being a-okay with whatever's gone on in the past couple fight.
Salsi got the kill with his ignite there. That's why it was so far back behind the tower.
Okay. And we do see here that Salsi actually going to come in. The Moomoo ultimate and Nunu ultimate go off on the Scalaman.
Oh, the damage.
Even Oracle's Elixir too. That is going to go down. So Salsi picks up a kill there as they are just continuing to press this advantage over Pentachill right now. And despite looking super strong last game, Pentachill seems to be falling apart in their strongest part of the game.
There we see the combination of the Amumu ult and the Nunu ult right there, getting frozen in place for 2 seconds while Nunu's channeling that ult duration. And when an AP Nunu is channeling that, it just deals so much damage, absolutely incredible damage. Now, Tom, if you have a chance running the camera, if there's nothing going on in some other lanes, just try to watch mid for a minute or so and watch how Salsi is harassing DC Buddha's Anivia. He just throws out a snowball, takes a little bit of damage on the trade, and then immediately consumes a creep, and then he just keeps doing that over and over and over again. It's the most annoying thing to watch in lane over and over again. We actually do have a kill up in top lane. Wings of Death able to pick that one off. But AP Nunu, again, it's a very strong laning build. It's something you don't see that often because, again, it's not that useful out of lane, but very, very difficult to deal with in lane. Morgana is just about the only counter that I can think of. Maybe Morgana and Galio, perhaps, are about the only champs. But again, no one snowball deals that much damage, but the combination of many snowballs and consumes just allows you to sustain in lane and harass the other enemy over and over again. DC Buddha is not having a particularly fun time in mid.
No, he really isn't, despite being, the Cryo Phoenix there being entirely made of ice. He is actually suffering a lot of damage. That cooldown on the ice ball is actually only 5.64 seconds, too. So Salsi's able to spam those in lane. Like you said, he's just really dodging Anivia's spells, running around with a level 1 Blood Boil. The extra movement speed is letting him dodge whenever she puts the ultimate down, so he's not taking critical strike damage from Frostbite. Actually, there's going to be a little engage here. Nautilus pulls Natanwin into the tower, but not too much is going to get done. Aphromoo did get stunned by Anivia, but they just were not able to go in on this right now, afraid of Salsi. It looks like actually we see out of the corner of our eye over there, Kennen was coming down to help, but Wings of Death just immediately shut him down with a pull and an ultimate and just dealing a little bit extra damage. Actually couldn't even pan over in time because that's how quickly Kennen fell to Blitzcrank.
So unfortunate there, Blitzcrank is going now. Looks like he's going for that Trinity build. One of the things that we see here is after TSM Evo goes ahead and takes the bottom tower. Oh, we actually have an initiation right here. Natwin getting caught. Let's see if he manages to find his way out of this. He does get slowed by Lulu right there. Oh, he gets walled by Anivia, but here comes the cavalry. Amumu ult. Right now, we're going to see that Nunu ult as well. There comes the Lulu ult getting the knockup right now. We've got a nice team fight going on here as more people enter the fight. Aphromoo getting in here as well. There is a red buff on that Amumu, so it is slowing, and right there, they are going to pick this off. And here comes the Nunu ult going to get channeled, and that is just going to blow up the kill on Anivia, and that is going to make it out of there with no trouble. So reinforcements did arrive coming in to save Taric. One of the things I was trying to mention is we saw that the bottom lane tower go down here, and so immediately once that happens, Evo shifts their focus to mid, and they try to take that tower next, and that's why the pressure shifted there.
Mm-hmm. Tangy Time actually coming in here, trying to deal some damage. He's in the 2v1 against Amumu and Varus. That does not work out in his favor. He is just going to fall right then and there. And that was actually a very good chain of corruption from Aphromoo, catching the Anivia in addition to one more member from Pentachill there. Anivia got immediately egged after that, and then, well, we just saw the destruction that Salsi was able to deal with his needlessly large rod on his ability power Nunu build, instantly taking down the egg from full to nothing. So that is a very, very powerful Nunu right now. They are going to come in here and take this blue buff away. Blitzcrank actually is going to claim it for himself. That Blitzcrank right now, that build's interesting. 114 damage, and he builds straight armor penetration. Only 25 ability power, but he's dealing so much with those pulls and his ultimate that it's almost like he's dealing magic and regular damage. Waiting in this bush over here, runs into DC Buddha, and I'm not going to Raichu. He actually misses a pull there, so he is going to have to get away. But, you know, he just has that overdrive. He can just pop it right here. He's going to proc his Sheen just in case he needs to get into a fight. He's going to run away because right now, Anivia and Lulu, despite the movement speed buff, Nautilus even coming in here, they're just too slow of champions. A flash goes off, though. They do tag Wings of Death, but Wings of Death is immediately going to flash and get out of there. So despite all their best efforts there, Wings of Death just escapes, and you know, I was going to halt myself for a minute because it looked like he was running back in, but he is going to escape this time, and he's just going to fall back to his tower, and he's just doing a great job on that solo top Blitzcrank.
It's just too difficult to catch up to Blitzcrank once he pops that overdrive and starts to run away. We now actually see the Deathfire Grasp coming in onto that AP Nunu, and the champions are going to converge on from TSM Emo onto Kennen up here in top lane, and I don't think Tangy Time is going to make it out of this one. We'll see what he does. He actually running under the tower, taking tower shots on top of everything else. And poor Tangy Time, 1-6 on the game. If you look at the gold total, he's extremely underfarmed. He has less gold than anyone else in the game except his own support. And he only just barely out has more gold than the support. We actually also have a fight going on down here in bottom lane. Aphromoo taking a lot of damage right here. He is getting slowed. Dark Knight also so low, but he's going to be able to survive with the Lulu ult onto him. Let's see if Aphromoo is going to be able to make it out of here. He's continuing to stick around in the fight. I'm not sure why he did that. One Glitter Lance will finish him off right there. And I'm not going to Raichu. He's going to run back under the tower. But this may be a dangerous place for Lulu to be.
Look at the HP gain back from Salty. That's going to throw a snowball and then pop the ultimate and take the kill as he just stops channeling at the exact precise moment. I thought Salty was kind of low. Runs behind the tower, consumes a creep, and gets back to basically half HP. So he was fine for that as they just dive down on Lu and pick up another kill. It looks like Tangy Time's going to try to do something. Amumu and Nunu are kind of low right here. It's a little bit of a tongue twister. Ultimate goes off. He's just not dealing any damage right now. Dark Knight will come back in and pick up a kill onto Taric. Looks like Salty, though, is going to take down Kennen before. Four grades is able to pick up a double kill. And look at Unstoppable running away from Nautilus. Nautilus with his skills just barely off cooldown. Blitzcrank now comes in, knocks him up into the air. I don't think they're going to be able to catch up to Nunu here. Look at Dark Knight taking all the damage from Blitzcrank. He's attacking so fast with that overdrive.
With
level
Trinity
5
Force.
Now. That's just so much. He does have the Trinity Force. Very good point, Sola. All the damage coming out and pulls Anivia. Anivia trying to wall him off, but did not get a very good wall. Unstoppable just doing all the help he can with no mana and no health. And that is two kills now for Blitzcrank. Now flashing in to go in on the Lulu. I'm not going to Raichu taking a lot of damage. Unstoppable once again coming in for one tantrum. And that is going to be enough as Raichu tries to chase him down. Wings of Death legendary on his solo top Blitzcrank. Trinity Force in hand. He is just dominating the team Pentachill right now.
Unstoppable, the Amumu player, also does have mobility boots, so that's one of the reasons why he was able to just keep running once he's out of combat for, what is it, I believe 5 seconds, his movement speed picks up, and they're just not going to catch him. So a lot of very fast champions right now on TSM Evo between the Blitzcrank, between that. Right now, Amumu going back in right there, going to pick off another kill right there after we're going to claim that one. And this game is starting to turn far, very, very far against Pentachill, starting to turn into a little bit of the Lapper phase here.
Yeah, just a little bit. We did see Aphromoo with a nice chain of crush, and as soon as Kennen tried to Lightning Lush in, Salty, though, a little overextension there. He does consume a minion, but tower shots deal a little bit more damage than most of the damage he's taking in this game. Unstoppable gets exhausted, but keeping that flash up goes over the wall. Nat Nguyen's going to go in here. Actually, look at Aphromoo just immediately egging DC Buddha, but he is actually going to fall with the Mind Power. Gray's actually picking up a lot of kills right now. Unstoppable does eventually go down after not going back for the longest amount of time as Nautilus picks up a kill onto Amumu. 4-1 on Graves right now. He is a lot of the damage. Once again, Dark Knight, the AD player, 14 Pentachill, really doing all the damage he can to help out his team. Looks like Nautilus is going to pop the Titan's Wrath Shield, try to get under the turret, but no avail. He is going to Dredgeline out of there. And I don't think they're going to be able to go down onto Nat Nguyen's Taric here. They may try to push the tower or maybe back off and just go back to the laning phase. I don't think that's the smartest move right now, as Pentachill is just super, super behind right now. 34k to 26k, 18 kills to 8, and they are down 4 towers right now. And this Blitzcrank continuing to roam around with double buff now, has an additional Zeal on top of his Trinity Force. That Blitzcrank is super fast right now, Sola.
And Pentachill probably, if they're still trying to win the game, and I'm not sure that they are because they've been throwing out some surrender votes here that haven't gone through, but they probably should have gone and tried to do Dragon right there. Dragon was up, and they could have taken it. They did have four members of their team right there. Still, their overall position is not great. The only reason they won that last fight is Evo just being a little bit too much troll, diving into the enemy base, fighting when they didn't have numbers. Right now, uh-oh, Tiny Time getting caught out once again. Blitz with all that movement and a red buff. I don't think he's going to be able to get out of this. Tiny Time does pop his Lightning Rush, but again, Blitz is just so fast. Is he going to be able to run this down? He does get stunned by Kennen's ultimate. Is he going to be able to get this? There's an angry robot on your tail. Can you get out of there? No, not going to make it out. So no. Wings of Death continuing to go legendary right there. And again, that top lane has just gone really, really poorly for Pentachill in this particular game.
Yeah, as you mentioned before, last game was a weak spot for Pentachill, and they were able to supplement it with the Nocturne gank. Nautilus not being as fast of a jungler, not just letting his presence known on the map nearly as much as he did on the Nocturne from last game, as bottom tower falls down here to Aphromoo. He just wasn't able to just really make up for the fact that top lane was spiraling out of control in favor of TSM Evo, and we saw just how much work Nocturne was doing last game and the amount of damage that Blitzcrank was able to deal out of the top lane in this game number two. So very, very good positioning from Wings of Death. Very good spot for TSM Evo. Looks like they could potentially take down this bottom tower. They are possibly go onto the inhibitor right now. I really don't know what Pentachill can do to really defend against this. Once again, Wings of Death just not with this team, but they are not able to really do anything. Nautilus is just taking shots from Varus. I don't think he's really able to go in on anything. Smokescreen does go down from Graze. Looks like a flash and a pull down onto Aphromoo, but he gets stunned by the Dazzle. The rest of the team, meanwhile, is going to go in. Curse to the side mummy goes off. They try to focus down Graze. He gets the Lulu ultimate. Even that looks like to be not enough. A lot of damage do go down onto Nunu and Taric, but Blitzcrank comes in and gets a triple kill with one ultimate. That is going to be a quadra kill now, as everybody except for Kennen on Pentachill is dead right now. Wings of Death, is he going to go for the Penta? No, there's not going to be no Penta kill, as it looks like that Pentachill has enough of that fight. TSM Evo going to take the match 2-0, Sola.
No, that one, unlike the first game, this one really just wasn't that close. Not really that even of a match. TSM Evo getting out ahead, and that top lane was sheer utter destruction, with Wings of Death going legendary in the game. And there just wasn't a whole lot that Pentachill could do in that game. They looked good for about 5 minutes, and after that, it just all went horribly wrong, and we're not able to overcome the strength of TSM Evo.
No, it was just a little bit too much Evo dominance.